Like it or hate it, Family Guy is a cultural monolith. On and off the air since the end of the 20th century, the animated sitcom that popularized cutaway gags has currently broadcast 20 seasons and almost 400 episodes, becoming a financial juggernaut for Fox through its staying power and success in syndication. And while the show's quality and its effect on adult animation that would follow can be argued, its objective success and popularity definitely can't. At the cusp of the 2010s, this popularity had reached an all-time high, earning talks of a Family Guy theatrical film, a spin-off in the form of The Cleveland Show, and various multimedia adaptations that helped launch creator Seth MacFarlane into mainstream stardom. Most of these were pretty bad, but anyone trying to see for themselves can find them all without much effort, with only one major exception. In 2012, 20th Century Fox set out to create a Family Guy venture like no other, developing an online MMO aimed at immersing fans in the world of Quahog and bringing them together like never before. Family Guy Online, as the game would be creatively called, ran for nearly a year before being taken down, and has been completely inaccessible ever since, leaving it lost. On this Lost Media Monday, we'll take a look at the brief history of Family Guy Online, its closure, and why the hunt to bring this indescribably niche project back to life is easier said than done. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, try new things, fall in love, always believe in yourself, and never give up. Let's go. I won't pretend that the start of the 2010s were an interesting time. Popular media hinged on edgy comedy, directionless pop music, a boom in reality TV, and in an example that will be important soon, Facebook. Video games were in a similar cultural lull. Led by the massive success of platforms like the Wii and Apple's iPhone App Store, the medium became increasingly focused on the casual audience, with ideas and designs aimed more towards making things accessible to the lowest common denominator than catering to any sort of educated core demographic. They canceled the Darth Maul game for this. Led by games like Angry Birds and Facebook's Farmville, this simplified approach to game design, usually marked by a free price tag with in-game purchases to generate revenue, represented massive potential cost-profit margins for gaming companies, and by extension, the rights holders of any game that was based on a licensed property. Enter 20th Century Fox, rights holders of edgy humor's most popular child, Family Guy. The franchise had passed $1 billion in revenue as of 2008, now had a successful spin-off, and was consistently one of the most liked pages on Facebook during the site's peak popularity. Given the show's profit-making profile, and the huge overlap the show's appeal had with the audience participating in this new, small-scale world of gaming, Fox saw Family Guy as the perfect face for a low-cost, microtransaction-filled digital experience.
Stop smiling! 90% of the people playing this are pooping!
Family Guy Online was announced in July of 2011 as a free-to-play MMO that let fans create their own avatars and set out on allegedly hilarious adventures across the world of Quahog. Marketed as an MMOL.
Family Guy is an MMOL, if you want. So it's massively multiplayer laugh out loud.
The game would allow players to take on missions from the series' wide range of existing characters, with series writers Andrew Goldberg and Alex Carter contributing to the game's dialogue. A corresponding interview with Gary Rosenfeld, Fox Consumer Products VP for New Media, also emphasized the game's intended audience, specifically pointing to the emerging casual market as a point of interest.
We're targeting a space kind of between social games and hardcore online games called accessible games. We want a game that is compelling and will engage a quote-unquote core gamer, but also has enough in it and is easy enough to get into that someone who is not a quote-unquote core gamer will enjoy what they're doing.
Oh, here we go.
From the start, it was clear the game was never destined for greatness. Development was being handled by Roadhouse Interactive.
Roadhouse.
A neophyte studio with no published games, it was being created using the Unity engine, which at the time couldn't power more than iPhone apps and Cartoon Network's Fusion Fall. Despite this, Roadhouse deserves credit for taking an ambitious approach to the title, trying to create something fully fleshed out that could serve as both an immersive Family Guy experience and as a capable video game in its own right. Family Guy Online was released as a public beta on April 17th, 2012, and the game was pretty standard as far as MMOs go. Players would first select a class based on the show's characters, There was Stewie, Brian, Peter, Lois, or Chris and Meg, who shared a class. Then, after creating their avatar, players would be dropped in front of the Griffin household, where they could begin accepting missions from the family and other characters around town. As far as the gameplay elements, combat was extremely simple, movement was a bit janky, and despite being free to play, an in-game shop would prompt players to purchase skills, character slots, and more. The Family Guy elements were more fleshed out. The fictional Rhode Island town of Quahog was set out on a large scale, with meticulous recreations of the show's settings included. Players could see this immediately, as they were transported to a fully modeled 3D version of the Griffin family home to begin the game. Adam West and other series regulars also speak to the player with original voice acting, though this only applies to some of the game's dialogue.
We lead the nation in home invasion, murder, rape.
The game also includes various jokes and cutaway gags from the show, displayed on an in-game pop-up monitor as a reward for completing missions. If the game continued, it's likely this could have been used to promote upcoming episodes through exclusive clips and the inclusion of new gags. Overall, it was a passable game, which is shocking considering its specs, but within a very short time frame, the same qualities that made Family Guy work as a game would also serve as its ultimate undoing.
Ah, Peter, it's okay. It's just death.
Oh, thank God.
Hey, did someone choke on a roll in here?
Oh, no. I spit it up.
Oh.
Roadhouse Interactive's goal was to make Family Guy Online accessible to both casual and hardcore gaming audiences. Unfortunately, MMOs have proved to be a poor genre to explore that concept in. The casual market found themselves entering the game and not doing much else, while hardcore players saw very little to make them want to keep playing. This led to a struggle for the game to succeed as a game, eventually functioning as little more than an online chat room with Family Guy icons. Just under a year after the release of its public beta, the game was turning into a disaster. Lobbies maxed out at just 200 simultaneous players at their peak, and those who kept playing didn't do much to sustain the game financially. Additionally, the lukewarm release of another Family Guy video game, Back to the Multiverse, had Fox worrying about the viability of the show when it came to the digital space. Because of this, it was announced on December 24th, 2012, that Family Guy Online would not be exiting beta, and would instead shut down in January of 2013. When it was announced, Play for Real Gaming published a scathing article about the title and its seemingly undereducated player base, stating that their inability to complete even the game's first missions played a major part in its demise. After shutdown, the browser-based game became completely inaccessible. While Family Guy would return to the medium through a variety of small-scale mobile games, Roadhouse Interactive would close in 2016, with Family Guy Online ending up as the most prolific project in the studio's lifetime. Efforts to revive the title have come up empty as well. The game's browser-based nature means that its files couldn't be downloaded directly by players, its out-of-date engine means it lacks any support for current browsers, and a sign-in page restricting the game's website prevented anything from being recorded by the Wayback Machine. Barring any intervention from former Roadhouse employees, this means that Family Guy Online is truly lost. It was a strange idea from the start. And while fans of the show may see this now and feel like they missed out on a rare way to interact with the series and its world, they can rest easy, knowing all they really missed out on was about 100 people in a circle shouting Family Guy quotes.